Yeah, my name's Dave Wheelock, and I'm gonna maybe get on the other side of the fence a little bit. I'm a retired land use administrator and a certified planning and zoning administrator, so maybe I can answer some of your questions, although I'm not a specialist in solar farms. And I have no one way or the other in this. I do live in the ETJ. It's difficult for a municipality to give up a ratable that won't have any services provided to them. No water, no sewage, no roads, just taxes every year. So I know that that's on your mind, and it's going to be a difficult decision for you to do. To the young lady who was worried about the solar farm in Bath, that was due to a lack of land use ordinances in Beaufort County. And once that got started, I did know that the planning board and the county did come up with an ordinance that hopefully will satisfy some of those problems in the future. Again, it's a difficult decision, but it's difficult that it does go both ways. I've never heard of anything like this where it would detract from your taxes or your real estate value. It would certainly either keep your real estate value the same or add to it, because you're getting taxes from them, which is going to allow Chocolatey to keep the budget at a level pace. As far as once you set a precedent with a conditional use, you're not really doing that, because any other solar farm or commercial industry is still going to have to come before the committee, and a separate decision will be made at that time. And as far as worrying about the residential area and setbacks there, it's zoned for residential, and again, the planning board and town would have the right to have setbacks in that residential area, half-acre lots, acre lots, quarter-acre lots. So there's a lot of worries and questions in here that I understand completely, but can't be answered by voting on this ordinance tonight. So I just wanted to add that from my experience.
Anybody else?
I just want to mention a couple of things. I don't live outside all of the jurisdictions, but some discussion some time ago about putting a solar farm across the road from us, and I spent a lot of time on it, and look, I feel when I read these things might be contaminated. You've got runoff from the pounds. What's going to happen when you do with the pounds if they are contaminated? I understand that the process you use to make them are contaminated, so therefore, something's got to be contaminated. And I have health issues concerned with.
Okay. Yeah, so there was some negative press around a certain type of solar manufacturing years ago called thin film solar, where they were using a chemical called cadmium telluride in the manufacturing process. And there was some concern that if the glass sheet that keeps that cadmium telluride protected from the weather was to crack, there could be some contamination. But the industry has completely moved away from that technology. The technology that we use is called polycrystalline solar, or polycrystalline silicon, which is basically made from sand. It's melted sand. And then there's glass and a Tedlar backsheet that's made at DuPont down in Fayetteville. So, you know, not to say that your point doesn't have any merit, because it did at one point. I think there were some bad practices in the way that modules were being made. But there's nothing unsafe in the modules that we use. The water does run right off the modules, but there's nothing to leach into the soil because there's no dangerous chemicals in the modules themselves.
Are panels still made in China?
Some of them are. We've worked with a company called REC, which is a Norwegian company, for most of our projects. And so it either comes from China or from Singapore.
Well, I read these are moving overseas with possible contamination. Anyway, that's all I have to say.
I just had a question about the animal on the front here. You said there was a smell coming with it. And how does that work?
Yeah, so on our rural farms, we've typically used sheep inside the fence to keep the grass mowed down. It's less noisy than using lawnmowers all the time. And it's a more environmentally friendly practice to do it that way, and it gives a local farmer the chance to make a little revenue off the project as well. But I do understand that there's some concern about whether that would be allowed inside the town limits anyway, so we may not be able to do it on this project.
Would you plan to currently?
We would if we were allowed to, I think, because it's just...
So that's
we prefer to work with a local farmer to do sheep rather than have to use lawnmowers all the time. They create a lot of noise and, exhaust and all that. So.
Okay. My name is Biff Matthews. Just have a real quick question. I did drive up to Bath and took a look at those units. One of the things that was very disconcerting to me was the number of really, really large lights that were around those facilities. Are we going to, if this is approved, are we going to see those lights? And what is the purpose of those? Because that's a tremendous amount of light pollution.
Right. No, not at all. We drove up there today, actually, and took a look. Those aren't our projects, but what I suspect is that those are lights that they put up during construction to try to keep people from breaking in and trying to steal equipment, and that they'll take them down at the end of construction. I don't know that for a fact, but we don't have any lights on any of our farms. We've looked at the idea of putting security lights, but it just doesn't make sense. I mean, you're not going to catch any thieves with lights flashing everywhere.
Anybody else? Can I ask one more question, Mayor? On your drawing, or your map that you have, this is showing a Google Earth map, and it's dated, and this was what you said, right? And it's dated February 20 of 13. Okay, so I guess I'm a little curious, because when you look at the map that you produced here, that's your map, okay? I guess I'm a little taken back that you guys have been looking at the site, planning the site for over a year, obviously, based on your map.
Well, that's the data of the satellite image,
right? Okay, not our. It's not our image. It's a
Google Earth imagery.
Okay, but it was created a year ago.
The satellite picture that we're using to show the drawing on.
Okay.
Really available to the public. No, it's just public information.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we have been looking at the site for several months, but going through the process of getting our due diligence and everything, we have to submit applications to the utility and all this stuff to see if we can even do it.
Okay. Well, I guess my point was, just looking at that, I was interested in how long you guys had been pursuing this site, and in the last 30 days, I think, is that right, Mayor? About the last 30 days that the town has begun, the public has begun discussing, I don't know what y'all been doing, but the public has been made aware of in the last 30 days or something, on something that will be a long-term impact. It does cause a lot of concern.
So we had done some due diligence stuff before we came to the town with the idea, because we don't want to waste anybody's time with something that the utility's not going to be okay with.
Anybody else?
Now it's time to speak if you got any questions. Okay. We'll close the public hearing. Open up our regular meeting. We have your minutes and your financials. If you have any questions, corrections.
Yeah. $500.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?